Hey, welcome to Hidden Indie Gems, where we embark on a journey into the vibrant world of indie gaming. Join me as we delve into the creative minds behind current and future indie games, uncovering what sets each one apart and makes it truly extraordinary. Today, I got a chance to talk with solo game developer Bruno Bombardi. He is currently working on his title, Dunjungle, a 2D action-packed roguelike about an ape protecting the jungle from the rise of a corruptive power. Explore ever-changing dungeons, fight weird enemies, and gear up with lots of weapons and relics you can combine for a new experience every run. Now, this podcast has no sponsors and is 100% audience-funded. If you want to support my creative work, you can buy me a coffee using the link in the description. Every dollar makes a huge difference. Thank you, and enjoy the show. So, Bruno, tell me how you got started as a game developer.
Well, I got started, actually, I think the first thing I did, like a game developer, was level editing in a game called N. Maybe you know it, N++.
Oh, yes. Yeah, I do know that game.
I was in high school and I made some games to play with my friends. I really had a lot of fun seeing them play my levels and die a lot. And I think that's what really got me started. Then I studied programming, and the next natural step was going into game dev.
Tell me about your game then, Dunjungle. What kind of game is it?
Well, Dunjungle is a roguelite with a T. Maybe some people on the internet can get angry if you say the wrong letter. At first, it was supposed to be a roguelike with no permanent progression systems. But then playing more and more games, I realized adding some permanent progression system make it easier for less skilled players, and I want everyone to be able to enjoy Dunjungle. So yeah, I went with that.
I downloaded the demo yesterday and I played it for like maybe 20 minutes, 30 minutes, and it was very fun. When did the demo come out?
The last demo, the one that you played, I think it's been there for about 2 months. I plan to upload a new one maybe in October, in the next Steam Fest. Yeah, I'm aiming toward that one because I want to release the game this year, at the end of the year. If not, then should not be later than February 2025.
Tell me a little bit more about the game. So how did you first come up with the idea? And then how did you get to where it is now?
To be honest, I was playing a lot of Dead Cells. At the time, it was the pandemic. I had more free time than usual. I haven't made games at that point for the last 3 or 4 years. And I decided to make my own roguelite because I was enjoying it so much. And I had a bit more free time in my hands. And I was bored of my shop too. So yeah, I started creating my own little roguelite. It was supposed to be little. Now, 4 years later, I'm still developing it because I kept adding stuff. I'm happy. I'm happy that about how it's turning up.
Can you describe some of the gameplay mechanics? What are some of the unique things that you see in the game?
Well, the most unique things, I think, is monkeys. Aside from that, I'm still working on this, but I think meaningful choices is my priority when designing the gameplay. And this is not in the demo, but I'm designing a class system to help enhance this feeling of each run being unique and being able to adopt different strategies to go through the game. So you'll have your tanky, strong character, maybe it's slow. You have your speedy, critical, dodgy one. You have your spellcasting wizard like, and some other a bit more more unique one, like maybe a trainer, and you have to use familiars and summons, maybe a primitive one, and you can only use your fists and throw stones. Helps that you're a monkey. I think it really goes well with the theme. I don't want to spoil it, but yeah, I want to, for players to be able to go through the game again and again and really keep it fresh.
Tell me a little bit more about some of the things, items that people can find in the game. What are some weapons that people can use? What are some of the enemies that people can encounter?
Well, you'll find, talking about enemies, you'll find all sorts of animals. Some are real and some are not, or some are mixes between different animals. Some can be fishes with legs. But yeah, it's mostly animal. About the skills you can find. Well, something I like about video games, and maybe this is inspired by Metroidvanias such as Aria of Sorrow, is that you can use some skills that your enemies use. So as you go through the game, you'll see some enemies throwing things at you that you later can unlock and use yourself.
One thing that stuck out when I was playing the demo is that it had a really good sense of humor.
Yes, I think making people smile is one of the main reasons I got into game developing. And I just try to put my humor on it. I don't know. I try to be funny, and I think some people will find it funny. Maybe some others don't. But yeah, I think all my games will have that.
Let's say the game is out now. There's like 1,000 people that are playing it. What are you hoping they're feeling? What are they telling their friends? Oh, I'm playing this game, Dun Jungle. It's about this and that.
Well, I hope they like it. I hope they find it, as you say, funny. Because I love to make people smile. I hope they find it silly, but they're okay with that. And I hope they find it challenging, but fair. You don't want to feel like you lost because of the game. You want to feel that you lost because of your skills and you can just get better.
Where can people go learn more about Dun Jungle?
Well, I think the best way is wishlist Dun Jungle on Steam, because then you will get to know when it will be released. You get an email when Dun Jungle releases. And also, if they want more information, they can follow me on Twitter. It's Bruno Bombardi. I mostly post over there about the game.
Thank you so much for making time.
No, great. Thank you, Carlos. Thank you for inviting me.
Hey, thank you so much for listening. Make sure you subscribe to the podcast so that you don't miss a single episode. Leave a review, share with your friends. See you next time.